Vimochitaham cha sahatma cha vibho Dhyayeva nate namahur vipadganat Again. Yata Rishikesha Kalena Devaki
Yata Rishikesha Devaki
Kamsena Rudati Chiram Sucharpita Vimochitaham cha sahatma cha vibho Jayeva na te na mi mohor vipadganat
Jayeva na te na mohor vipadganat
Yata Rishikesha Kalena Devaki
Yata Rishikesha Kalena Devaki
Kamsena Rudati Chiram Suchartita.
Kamsena Rudati Chiram Suchartita.
Vimochitaham cha sahatma cha vibho.
Vimochitaham cha sahatma cha vibho.
Dayeva natena muhur vipadganat.
Dayeva natena muhur vipadganat.
O Rishikesha, master of the senses and lord of lords, you have released your mother Devaki, who was long imprisoned and distressed by the envious King Kamsa, and me and my children from a series of constant dangers. Queen Kunti is praying like this to Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna had to come to Mathura and deal with the envious King Kamsa. Kamsa was very afraid, because at the time of the marriage of his sister Devaki, there was an omen, a voice from the sky. Congratulations.
Yesterday we had told her that there was class, she knew, but still she asked me at 4:30, do we have class? But I didn't check my phone until 6:30, so maybe she's on the way.
Takes her 2 hours to come.
Yeah, she drives a motorcycle.
We got a Chinese book. We got the Chinese. You can read the Chinese translation.
Yeah, we
have it. Chinese Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam. First canto.
First canto.
It's Dipajang Ershisan.
Ajang Ersan Ye.
Kesha, 感官之主, 所有主人的主人, 您解放了您母亲 Devaki, 她曾被邪恶的康萨王长期关押, 过着痛苦的生活, 您也解救了我和我的孩子, 使我们脱离了一连串的危险。 邪恶的康萨王害怕被Devaki的第八个儿子Krishna杀死，于是便把Krishna的母亲、他自己的妹妹Devaki与他丈夫Vasudeva一起关进了监狱。他把Devaki生在生Krishna之前 生的所有的儿子都杀死了，但 Krishna 被转移到他的养父 Nanda 王的家中，所以逃离了这个屠杀孩子的刽子手的魔掌。Kunti Devi 跟他的孩子们也得到拯救，摆脱了一系列的危险。然而 Kunti Devi 得到了主 Krishna 更多的恩典，因为主 Krishna 并没有解救 Devaki 的其他儿子， 但却救了 Kunti Devi 的孩子们。他之所以这么做，是因为 Devaki 的丈夫 Vasudeva 还活着， 而 Kunti Davis 却是个寡妇，除了 Krishna 没人可以帮助他。结论是 Krishna 会给处在更危险境地的奉献者更多的帮助，他有时把他的奉献者置于这种危险的境地，因为在那种情况下无可奈何的奉献者会变得更依恋他，奉献者 越依恋至尊主就会取得越大的成功。
Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
So Queen Kunti is expressing her gratitude to Lord Krishna because Lord Krishna had saved her and her children from many dangers.
昆蒂王后她把她的处境告诉了 Krishna， 因为 Krishna 拯救了她跟她的孩子，在危险之中拯救了他们。
So Devaki and her husband Vasudev had been put into prison by Kamsa.
就是那个 Devaki 跟她的丈夫 Vasudeva 被 Kamsa 关进了监狱里面。
And now Kamsa is the brother of Devaki. They're brother and sisters.
就是康萨是 Devaki 的哥哥，他们是那个兄妹的关系。
Yeah, so sometimes you see even in the family, the relationships can be very bad.
所以我们可以也可以发现到，就是说，即使是同样的家人，一家人的关系有时候也是很糟糕的。
So Kamsa was very envious of.Krishna, and he was very envious of anyone who opposed him.
就是，那个康萨他其实是很嫉妒 Krishna， 然后甚至就是说，他无法接受能够
一个人反对他，
对，就是他没有办法接受任何反对他的人。
So.Lord Krishna had come from Vrindavan to Mathura.
So Krishna 从 Vrindavan 去到了 Mathura.
Kamsa was planning to kill Krishna.
那 Kamsa 就计划要去杀死 Krishna.
And he had arranged a big elephant right there.
他安排了一只大象。
Very nasty elephant.
就是
很坏的，
一只很暴躁的大象。
And when Krishna came there to the arena, the elephant attacked Krishna.
就当 Krishna arena
来到那个体育馆。
竞技场
。就 Krishna 到了竞技场的时候，然后那个大象就那个踢他。
But Krishna played with the elephant. He got behind the elephant. He hid from the elephant.
就是 Krishna 就像耍弄那个大象一样，这样。完全没有惧怕这样。
And finally, he killed the elephant.
然后最后他就杀死了那个大象。
And then Kamsa had arranged for the wrestlers.
Wrestlers.
摔跤。摔跤。
摔跤神手。
摔跤
神手。
摔跤。摔跤。
摔跤。摔跤人。
就是那个后来看啥就安排了一个摔跤的大力士选手。
And they were to fight Krishna and Balaram.
嗯，然后他们就跟 Krishna 跟 Balaram 就是打斗。
So Krishna and Balaram, they were only young boys. They were 11 years old.
嗯，就是。Krishna 跟 Balaram 那时候还是一个十一岁的小孩而已。
他们十一岁。So, but still, Krishna and Balaram they defeated these wrestlers.
嗯，所以 Krishna 跟 Balaram 还是就是打赢了
打
他们。
And then Kamsa was ready. Kamsa came running and got his sword and he's ready to attack Krishna.
嗯，就是那个康萨非常的拿着武器，
他的剑，
嗯，然后就跑向了 Krishna。英文太差了，英文太差了。
讲得很好。那比，
And Krishna then killed Kamsa, and with the death of Kamsa, then he brought Devaki and his mother and father, Vasudeva and Devaki, out from the prison.
嗯，所以他因为康萨就拿着剑就想要杀死 Krishna， 那最后还是被 Krishna 杀了。然后康萨死了以后，就是 Krishna 就得以把他的爸爸妈妈 Devaki 跟 Vasudeva 从监狱里面拯救出来。
So Prabhupada talks in the Purport about how Devaki and Vasudev, their sons were all killed by Kamsa.
嗯，就是圣帕乌帕老师在那个就是要旨里面有提到，就是说，在那 Krishna 之前 ，Vasudeva 跟 Devaki 的儿子都被 Kamsa 杀死了。
Right. Five sons.
嗯。
Six sons.
有
六个。The seventh son was Balaram.
第七个是 Balaram。
And Balaram transferred to the womb of Rohini.
那 Balaram 就是从 Devaki 的子宫转移到了 Rohini 的子宫。
And they thought Devaki had a miscarriage.
Miscarriage.
流产。
哦，流产了。就是，所以他们以为就是。那个 Devaki 流产了。
So then Krishna came the eighth child.
所以 Krishna 就成为第七个孩子，第八个孩子，第八个孩子。
So, Prabhupada said, why didn't Krishna save the other children of Devaki?
那帕乌帕有在提问说，那为什么？Krishna 不拯救其他的小孩呢
Krishna saved Kunti and her children from many dangers.
嗯，那因为 Krishna 拯救了 Kunti 跟他的儿子，在很多的一个危机的状况之下拯救了他们。
No, there were many things happened to Krishna, to Kunti and the Pandavas.
嗯，就是有很多的事情发生在 Kunti。跟就是潘达巴那个兄弟之间。
And Krishna saved them every time.
对，那 Krishna 每次都拯救他们。
But why didn't he save the children of Vasudeva and Devaki?
那为什么 Krishna 不拯救就是 Vasudeva 跟 Devaki 的小孩呢？
Well, he said, well, Devaki she has her husband.
嗯，就是因为
Devaki has her husband.
因为 Devaki 他的那个。老公，他的那个先生还在，他的丈夫还在。
Right, so she's okay, but Kunti didn't have anybody.
就是说，在这样的状况之下，就是他那个 Devaki 他的状况比较好。
So, we'll hear actually Krishna brought the six children back. Later.
Later. 但是事实上最稍后 Krishna 有把这六个小孩有带回来。
Yeah, it happened that Krishna and Balaram, they went to Sandipani Muni's ashram to get education. After they killed Kamsa, Vasudev and Devaki wanted Krishna and Balaram to get education.
就是在 Krishna 杀死了就是康萨王之后呢，那个 Krishna 的父母就是 Devaki 希望他能够去上学，能够受教育。
Because they had only been copper boys.
因为他们之前就只是牧牛童。
Vrindavan, the copper boys just go out with the cows every day, never went to school.
就是在Vrindavan的时候，他就只是一个牧牛童，成天跟牛群在一起，并没有去上学。
So they didn't know anything.
所以就是对知识一无所知，这样。
So Vasudev and Devaki had them go to.Sandipani Muni and learn everything.
所以，他的父母 Devaki 跟 Vasudeva 就送他去 Sandipani Muni 去上课。
And they learned all the 64 arts.
64 arts.
64.
64.
话题的教育。
他们就接受64项的一个教育，这样。
If you go there to the ashram, Sandipani Muni's ashram is at Avantipur. Now it's called Ujjain. Have you been to Ujjain? Did you go to Ujjain? Yes. So did you go to Sandipani Muni ashram? No, you didn't go.
就是昆曲拿去Sandipani Muni的那个ashram。上课，然后那个地方现在就是称为古晋。
古晋。
古晋。
古晋。We have ISKCON temple there. Bhakticharya Swami, you have a temple there.
在那里也有我们 ISKCON 的 temple.
So, Sandipani Muni Ashram there. And they have each of the 64 things they learned. There's a picture of each of the 64 arts.
在那个庙里面有64个壁画，就是在描述的我们所需要学习的64项的一个学习。
And they stayed there 64 days, one day for each art.
就是要画要每天学习一样要花64天。
And then after they learned everything, then Sandipani Muni said he wanted Guru Dakshin.
Guru Dakshin.
Sandipani Muni. Yeah.要一点布施。
就是他们在Sandipani Muni 结束了的学习课程之后，那个阿爽希望有一点布施，得到一些布施。
So he understood that Krishna and Balaram were not ordinary students; they were very special students.
那是因为他们知道，他们发现了，就是 Krishna 跟 Balaram 不是。一般的学生，他们是非常特殊的身份。
So he asked them, "Can you bring back my dead son?"
所以他就跟他们要求，就是说，请求他们，就是不是可以就是说，把他死去的儿子那个送回来。
He said, "Some time ago, my son died when he'd gone to the sea."Died in the ocean. So could you bring him back?
那个应该是住持吧，就是跟 Krishna 祈求说，因为他的儿子去海边，就是溺毙了，他是不是能够请求他，就是说 Krishna 能够把他儿子带回来
？So Krishna and Balaram went there, and they got him back.
所以。Krishna and Balaram 就去到了那里，去到了海边嘛，然后就把他的儿子带回来。
They didn't get him in the ocean. They had to go to Yamaraj.
他们并不是哦哦，对不起，他们不是去海边，他们是去阎罗王那里。嗯。
So,
阎罗王就把他还回来。
So Devaki had heard about this.
所以呢 ，Devaki 就听到了，就是这样的一个事迹。
So when Krishna and Balaram came.
所以当 Krishna 跟 Balaram 回来的时候
，Then Devaki asked what Krishna said. I know you brought your guru's son back to life.
嗯，然后他就跟 Krishna 讲说，哎，我听说你 guru 的儿子就是说回来了。
So can you bring back your six brothers also?
那他就询问说，你是不是同样的可以把你的前面六个兄弟也带回来？
So Krishna had to go and bring the six sons back.
所以 Krishna 就把那个 Devaki 的六个死去的小孩就送回来。
And when they came back, Devaki was so happy, milk began to flow from her breast.
就是当他的孩子都回来的时候，那 Devaki 就非常的开心，所以他的胸部就充满了那个乳汁。
And so she fed her breast milk to these six children.
那他也同时就是说哺乳这六个孩子。
But Krishna had already drank some milk from the breast of Devaki. Lord Krishna had already drank earlier.
就是那个 Krishna 早已经就是说喝过就是 Devaki 的母乳了。
So they all the six boys they got prasada.
所以因为 Krishna 已经喝过了母乳。所以呢，他其他六个兄弟，那个喝到的母乳就是 prasada。
And after they drank prasada, then they all went back to heaven.
所以，同样的，他的六个兄弟得到仁慈，就回到了天堂。
They were demigods.
然后他们是半神人。
They had been cursed. They had been cursed. 他们被诅咒。
So they've been cursed, so they fall down.然后他们六个本来是半神，因为被诅咒了，所以才那个堕落下来。
So Devaki and her husband, they had been put in prison for a long time.
所以 Devaki 跟她的丈夫在监狱里面度过了很长的时间。
Because of cancer being so envious.
就是因为康萨的一个嫉妒。
So envy is a very bad quality.
所以嫉妒是一种非常不好的一个品质。
In the material world, there's a lot of envy.
就是在我们的物质世界里面，就是嫉妒的状况是很多的。
But Lord Krishna says he spoke the Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna.Because Arjuna was not envious.
那Krishna 会跟 Arjuna 讲述《薄伽梵歌》，就是因为Arjuna 的品质，他不会嫉妒别人。
So, a devotee of Krishna is not envious of others.
所以就是Krishna 的奉献者是不会嫉妒其他人。
And in the Srimad Bhagavatam.It also says, in the beginning of the Bhagavatam, the beginning it says that this Bhagavatam is meant for these people, those people who are not envious.
所以在薄伽瓦坛一开始的时候就提到，就是说，这个书是给这些不会嫉妒的人。
Dhamma prajita kaitavo.Traparamo Nirmat Saranam Satam. Nirmat Saranam Satam. And this Bhagavad Purana is teaching the highest truth.
就是这个薄伽瓦坛是给就是说比较高品质的人的教育。
The highest.
最高品质的
真理。
的真理。
And it's for those people who are not envious.
然后特别是给那些不会嫉妒起不会嫉妒的人。
But people like Kamsa,
但是多数的人都像 Kamsa 一样，就是会嫉妒人。
So Lord Krishna, he had saved Vasudeva and Devaki from this Kamsa.
所以Krishna 就把 Vasudeva 跟那个 Devaki 从 Kamsa 手中拯救出来。
And he'd also saved Kunti and her children from a series of dangers.
那他同时也就是说从帮将 Kunti 跟他儿子跟他儿子们从很多的危难中拯救出来。
So we're going to hear about these dangers. Now we're going to hear about the dangers which Krishna saved Kunti and the Pandavas from.
Okay. 那我们现在来听听，就是那个 Krishna 拯救了 Kunti 皇后哪些危难。
Vishan Mahatne Purushada Darshanat
Vishan Mahatne Purushada Darshanat
Asat Tabaya Vanavasa Krishrata
Asat Tabaya Vanavasa Krishrata
Mride Mride Neka Maharatas Prato
Mride Mride Neka Maharatas Prato
Dronyas Pratas Chas Mahare Virakshita
Draya Ashratas Chas Mahare Virakshita
Vishan Mahatne Purushad Darshanat
Vishan Mahatne Purushad Darshanat
Asat Sabaya Vanavasa Krishrata
Asat Sabaya Vanavasa
Mride Mride Neka Maharatastrato
Mride Mride Neka Maharatastrato
Dronyastratas Chasma Harer Virakshita
Dronyastratas Chasma Harer Virakshita
Vishan Mahatne Purushada Darshanat
Vishan Mahatne
Asat Tabaya Vanavasa Krishrata
Asat Tabaya Vanavasa Krishrata
Mride Mride Neka Maharatastrato
Mride Mride Neka Maharatastrato
Dronyastratas Chasma Harer Virakshita
Dronyastratas Chasma Harer Virakshita
So Queen Kunti is going to tell us about the dangers Krishna saved Kunti and the Pandavas from.
So, 那个 Krishna 就要告诉我们，就是他是拯救了那个 Kunti， 他
Kunti 告诉，
Kunti 告诉，就是 Krishna， Kunti 告诉我们 Krishna 拯救了他哪些的那个危险，从哪些危险中拯救他。
My dear Krishna。Your Lordship has protected us from a poisoned cake, from a great fire, from cannibals, from the vicious assembly, from sufferings during our exile in the forest, and from the battle where great generals fought. And now you've saved us from the weapon of Ashwatthama.
亲爱的 Krishna 主啊，您把我们从下毒的糕饼、熊熊烈火、食人的生番、邪恶的家族聚会、苦难重重的森林流放生活，以及赫赫武将相星战的战场中救下。现在您再次搭救我们， 使我们免遭阿什瓦塔玛阿什瓦塔玛武器的伤害。
要指。
这节诗中列举了 Kunti Devi 与他的儿子们所遭受的危难。Devaki 有一次被他邪恶的哥哥置于困境，其他时候都很好，但 Kunti Devi 和他的儿子们一年复一年的被置于一个又一个的困境中。为争夺王国的统治权， Duryodhan 和他的党羽把 Kunti 的儿子们不断置于困境中，而每一次至尊主都救他们脱离险境。有一次Bhima被安排吃下有毒的糕饼，再一次他们被送进用虫胶盖的房子并遭到纵火。另外一次Drupadi被拖到众人面前，差一点被剥光衣服，在邪恶的库鲁家族成员的面前遭到羞辱。至尊主为Drupadi提供了无限长的衣料，使Duryodhan及其党羽没能看到他的裸体。同样，当他们被流放到森林中时，Bhima必须与名叫 Hidimba 的食人魔打斗，但至尊主救了他。事情并没有就此结束。在经历了所有这些苦难后， Kurukshetra 大战开打了。 Arjuna 必须与 Drona、 Bhishma 和 Karna 等伟大的战将以及所有强大有力的战士作战。最后甚至在一切都结束时， Dronacharya 的儿子还要发射 Brahmasetra 来杀害 Uttara 肚子里的孩子，而至尊主拯救了库鲁族幸存下来的唯一后代 Parikshita 王。
OK, so Queen Kunti is describing theFirst of all, she said, Krishna protected us from a poison cake.
所以就昆提就提到了，就是Kusha 拯救他儿子从这个有毒的糕饼中拯救出来。
Bhima is fond of eating. Bhima,
就是喜欢。
Yeah, Bhima is Vrikodara, right? Vrikodara means one who performs very great activities.
就是那个 Bhima 他展现的品质就是比较贪婪。
But he also likes to eat a lot.
他喜欢，他同时他也喜欢吃很多东西。
So the sons of Dhritarashtra, they knew that this Bhima likes to eat.
所以这个 Dhritarashtra 的儿子知道说 Bhima 他喜欢吃东西。
So they put there is a special cake full of poison.
所以他们就为他准备了一个特别的有毒的。糕点。
And Bhima saw the cake and he was very, oh, great, and ate the whole cake.
所以 Bhima 看到那个糕点以后就非常的贪婪，非常的开心的想的去吃它。
But it was poisoned, and so he fell unconscious. The poison took effect, and he was unconscious.
所以那因为是有毒药的关系，所以他吃了以后就失去了知觉。
So the sons of Dhritarashtra, they saw Bhima's body there. They thought, good, he's finished. And they threw his body into this lake.
就是那个 Dhritarashtra 儿子看到了，就是说 Bhima 的尸体以后，就把他丢到了那个湖里。
But in that lake, there were many poison fish.
在那个湖里呢，有很多有毒的鱼。
And the poison fish, they bit the body of Bhima.
那些有毒的鱼就吃了那个 Bhima 的身体。
And counteracted all the poison from the cake. It worked against the poison.
所以就同样的就把那个 蛋糕里面的那个毒素都吃掉了。
对，就 poison。
嗯，就以毒攻毒。
And Bhima came back to consciousness.
嗯，所以 Bhima 就这样就回来了，嗯，就恢复了知觉。
So he was saved.
嗯，所以他因此而被拯救。
And then the great fire, they had. What happened was, the sons of Dhritarashtra arranged a big. They built a big house, but they built the house out of a material which would go on fire very easily.
嗯，就是还有一次就是，康萨盖了一个，不是康萨，对，他们那个盖了一个房子给他们住，结果那个房子的材料是很容易被燃烧的。嗯
，Yes. And so the Pandavas they were warned by Vidura to be careful.
嗯，所以那个潘达瓦他们。就是需要时时刻刻很小心。
So the Pandavas, when they were staying in the house, they arranged, they built a tunnel out of the house to go through, to a tunnel out of the house to go into the forest.
所以
盖了一个小一小，
就是对，就是那个潘达瓦他们呢。为了安全的到森林，所以他们挖了一个地道。
And what happened one night, when they were staying there, one other woman came there with her five sons, and they wanted shelter.
嗯，就是有一天有一个女士跟她的五个带了五个小孩过来，他们想要得到庇护。
So the Pandavas and Queen Kunti welcomed them, and they gave them some room there in the house.
那个潘达瓦跟就是昆蒂，就热烈的欢迎他们进来，然后还给了他们一间房间。
But that night, that was the night the house got set on fire.
但是那个晚上，那个房子就着火了。
So the five Pandavas and Queen Kunti they could escape through the tunnel.
嗯，那个潘达瓦五兄弟跟昆蒂，那他们就从那个地道逃走了。
But this old lady with her five sons, they died in the fire.
但是这个老妇人跟她的五个儿子就死于火中。
So when the fire finished, then they found the bones of five young men and one old lady.
所以就是。当他们那个火灾过后，在检查这个灾后现场的时候，他们发现到了一具女人的尸体跟五个年轻人的尸体。所以他们就认为说啊，那这个就是昆蒂跟潘达瓦兄弟的尸体。然后底下人就回报说，哎，他们已经死了。但事实上他们还活着。
And the sons of Dhritarashtra, they were very sore, very sad, but in their minds, in their heart, they were thinking very good.
就是那个Dhritarashtra 表现出好像很悲伤、很伤心、难过，但事实上他心里是很高兴的。
So Krishna saved them.
所以 Krishna 再次从大火中拯救他们。
And then the vicious assembly, this was in the gambling match with the sons of Dhritarashtra.
然后有一次就是他们有一个赌跟那个 Dhritarashtra 的儿子有一场赌博。
When they had gambled even and they lost even Draupadi.And then they tried to take off Draupadi's sari.
那这场赌博中，那个潘达瓦五兄弟他们失去了输掉了Draupadi，然后那个Dhritarashtra的儿子们想要就是说要把那个Draupadi的衣服把它脱掉。
But Krishna protected Draupadi.
但是Krishna 保护了 Draupadi。
Krishna came to society.
No, Krishna.
Unlimited salary.
Krishna 就给了他一件，就是说那个无止境的沙利。
And then Krishna saved them from sufferings when the, because the Pandavas had gambled with the sons of Dhritarashtra, so they had to go into the forest and stay in the forest for 12 years.
就是因为在这场赌博之中，他们赌输了，所以他跟那个 Dhritarashtra 儿子们赌博赌输了，所以他们必须要到森林里面，流放到森林里面，在森林里面待12年。
But Krishna always would come and visit them and encourage them, and he would protect them from suffering.
那在这段时间 ，Krishna 常常去拜访他们，常常去看他们，同时也鼓励他们，然后拯无数次的拯救他们从一些苦难之中拯救出来。
And then the battle where great generals fought, that is the battle of Kurukshetra.
然后同样的，在那个 Kurukshetra 的战争中，也保护了他们。
Lord Krishna was fighting, was not fighting. He was only the chariot driver for Arjuna.
那这场战争中 ，Krishna 并没有亲自参与作战，他是作为 Arjuna 的一个战车的。就是Krishna 总是在保护着他们。
So they came out on top.
所以他们就是能够从这些苦难中。
And then after the battle of Kurukshetra, then Ashwatthama. Attacked, he threw the Brahmastra weapon at Uttara to try to kill the child in her womb.
就是在那个战争之后，那个对不起，人民太多了。人民太多了，抱歉。
Krishna saved.Krishna saved Uttara.
Krishna 救了 Uttara.
Because Ashwatthama threw the weapon.
因为那个 Ashwatthama 他使用了一个武器。
Tried to kill the child in her womb.
他使用这个武器想要杀害 Uttara 肚子里面的孩子。
But Krishna protected the child.
那 Krishna.就是保护了这个孩子。
So, this so many times the dangers were there.
就是说经常有就是危险在那边。
But Krishna came and helped Kunti and the Pandavas to overcome all the dangers.
但是 Krishna 总是会出现，然后帮助他们帮助他们就是能够克服这些困难。
So this brings us to this most wonderful verse in the prayers of Queen Kunti.
那这是一个很好的一个很优雅的一个诗节。
Very important verse.
是非常重要的一个诗节。
Everyone chant.Vipada Shantu Dashasvat
Vipada Shantu Dashasvata
Vipada Shantu Dashasvat
Vipada Shantu Dashasvata
Vipada Shantu Dashasvat
Vipada Shantu DashasvatTatra
Tatra Jagadguru
Tatra Tatra Jagadguru
Bhavato Darshanam Yachyat
Bhavato Darshanam Yachyat
Bhavato Darshanam Yachyat
Bhavato Darshanam Yachyat
Apunar Bhavadarshanam
Apunar Bhava Darshanam
Apunar Bhava Darshanam
Apunar Bhava Darshanam
Vipada Shantuta Shasvat
So that we could see you again and again. For seeing you means we will no longer see repeated births and deaths.
译文，我愿所有那些灾难能一再到来，好让我们能一次又一次地见到您。因为见到您意味着我们不用再面对生死轮回。要旨，盖瓜说来，从事过一些虔诚活动的苦恼之人、贫穷之人、有智慧的人和好奇爱问的人，会崇拜或开始崇拜至尊主。其他一位从事罪恶活动的人，无论其身份地位如何，都因为被错觉能量误导而无法接近至尊主。当灾难降临时，虔诚的人就会毫不犹豫地托庇于至尊主的莲花烛，时刻铭记至尊主的莲花烛，意味着为摆脱生死而做准备。因此我们欢迎所谓灾难的降临，因为灾难给我们想起至尊主的机会，而想起至尊主就意味着解脱。至尊主的莲花烛被视为是用来跨越无知海洋的最合适的船只，托庇于至尊主莲花烛的人获得解脱，就像抬腿跨过牛犊的蹄子踩在地上形成的蹄蛙一样容易。这样的人适合住在至尊主的居所，他们与步步为机的地方毫无关系。在《博迦梵歌》中，至尊主说，这个物质世界是灾难重重的危险地带，智力欠佳的人不知道这个地方的本质就是灾难重重，因此还忙着制定计划要解决那些灾难。他们对至尊主的住所一无所知，那里充满极乐，丝毫没有灾难的踪迹。在物质世界里，无论环境如何，灾难都是要发生的，所以明智之人应该不受尘世灾难的打扰。在忍受各种各样不可避免的灾难时，我们应该不断提高我们的灵性觉悟，因为这是人生的使命。灵魂超越所有的物质灾难，因此所谓的灾难是假的。一个人也许在梦中看到老虎正在吞食他，而他会为这场灾难而哭喊，但事实上并没有老虎，也没有痛苦，他所经历的只是一场梦而已。同样道理，我们生活中的所有灾难都是梦。人如果足够幸运，能经风爱服务与至尊主接上关系，他就赢得了一切。通过九种风爱服务中的任何一种服务与至尊主接触上，都永远是在回归守神的路途上向前迈出一步。
So often we find people come to Krishna consciousness, they think that because we're devotees, there should not be any problems.
我们有时候会看到有些人来接触了Krishna意识之后，我们会想说，我们现在是奉献者了，应该不会有什么问题。
Yeah, we think I'm a devotee now.
会想说我现在是奉献者了，
so I shouldn't suffer.
我应该不会有什么痛苦。
But actually we see there's a lot of suffering in the world.
但是我们可以看到说，其实 这世界上还是有很多的苦难。
Devaki and Vasudev suffered. They were put into the prison house of Kamsa.
像 Devaki 跟 Vasudev 他们所遭受 的苦难，就是被关在被 Kamsa 关在监狱里。
They were very great devotees.
他们都是非常虔诚的奉献者。
They were the parents of Lord Krishna.
他们是 Krishna 的父母。
But they were put through many suffering, many difficulties.
但是他们还是经历了许多的一个苦难痛苦。
And similarly, Queen Kunti and her sons, the Pandavas, they suffered also a lot.
那就像那个 Kunti 跟他的五个儿子。他们也同样经历了很多的一个苦难。
They were great devotees.
他们也都是伟大的奉献者。
But they had many, many difficulties.
但是他们还是遭遇到了很多的困难。
So we should not think that because we're chanting Hare Krishna and because we've taken shelter of Krishna that there won't be trouble.
所以我们不应该有这样的想法，说我们是奉献者，我们就是托庇在 Krishna 莲花烛下，我们就不会有任何 的问题。
We have to understand the nature of this material world is there will be problems.
就是我们需要了解到，就是说在这个物质世界，本质上就是有很多的问题。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Abrahma Bhuvana Loka Puner Avartano Arjuna. From the highest planet of Brahma down to the lowest, all are places of birth and death, are all places of misery.
就是Krishna 跟 Arjuna 说，就是即使是从最高的一个星球或者到最低等的一个地方，就是都是充满了，都是充满了那个那个 mystery， 都有生老病死，然后也有一些幻 mystery， 一些幻境，
痛苦。
所以我们是无法逃离这些痛苦。
But what we have to learn is how to act when the difficulties come.
就是我们需要学习的是说，当这些困难来临的时候，我们应该怎么行动。
And what we have to do is take shelter of Krishna.
我们所要做的就是托庇在Krishna。
Have to read the books.
我们需要阅读书籍。
And you have to chant the holy name.
我们需要就是那个念诵圣名。
People like Prahlad Maharaj, who was a great devotee.
人们都喜欢 Prahlad， 经历过许多的危险。
Yes, we heard in the previous verse, Lord Krishna had saved them from many dangers.
我们在前一个诗节，看到就是 Krishna 从很多的危险当中把他们拯救出来。
So Queen Kunti is saying that these dangers can happen again and again.
所以昆蒂皇后甚至希望说这些灾难能够一再的到来。
Because when there's dangers, when there's trouble, difficulties, then we will think of Krishna.
因为当这些困难，当这些麻烦的这些痛苦到来的时候，可以让他想起了 Krishna。
Sometimes they will say, "Dukhisoni sukra." Right? Sukra. No, dukhisoni sukra. No, the other way around. Sukra, dukhisoni.and the meaning, and when we're in distress, we'll think of God. If we're happy, We'll think of our money.
当我们在高兴的时候，是又想到了钱。
When we're happy, we're not worried about. We don't think about God very much. You know, we just enjoy the money.
当我们有钱的时候呢，我们很少想到那个主，然后我们只是在享受这个有钱的快乐。
But when we're in trouble, when we're in difficulty, we'll think of God.
我们只有在那个遇到了困难麻烦的时候，才会想到神。
But so we could see, you know, it's also like this here. Queen Kunti is also saying that the let the difficulties come, then I'll remember God more.
所以。就即使是像那个昆蒂皇后，她在这里她也说到了，就是那个因为遇到了困难，让我们的想到了主。
But we should think of God all the time.
但是我们应该要时时刻刻的记得主。
When you're happy and when you're in distress, you should always think of God.
就是不管我们是在开心的时候，或是低落的时候，我们都应该要想着主。
We don't have to worry. The troubles will come in the course of time. We don't have to pray for them.
就是，我们不应该去那个想着说这些困难的到来。
No, they will come naturally. 因为
他们很自然的，就是会有这些困难到来。
So we don't have to worry about that.
所以我们。不需要去烦恼这些事情。
One man said to me, he said, I'm not asking for any trouble.
有人说我不去那个那要求有任何的问题。
But I said, well, the trouble comes anyway, whether you ask for it or not.
就是我并没有要求那些那个困难，但是这些麻烦事情总是会发生过来。
Anyway, Queen Kunti was appreciating all the troubles which she went through. Queen Kunti, she appreciated.
就是昆蒂皇后，她反而很感谢，就是说，这些困难的到来。
Because they helped her to become more Krishna conscious.
因为这些困难的处境。反而让他可以，就是说，更加投入的有库西纳意识。
So we shouldn't, we should be happy when the difficulties come.
所以我们应该感到高兴，当我们遇到了困难的时候。
We shouldn't think, oh, how could Krishna do this to me?
我们应该想说，啊，为什么库西纳对我做这些事情
？I'm a good person.
我是一个好人。
I never did any bad thing.
我从没做什么坏事。
Why Krishna let this happen to me?
为什么 Krishna 让这个不好的事情发生在我身上呢
？No, a devotee will think, thank you, Krishna.
但是如果是一个奉献者，他会想说啊，谢谢 Krishna。
We thank Krishna for the trouble and for the happiness. It's all Krishna's mercy.
我们奉献者会感谢 Krishna 所给的，就是这些，不管是那个困难、麻烦或是快乐的事情。
One of the devotees, this one devotee I know, he was distributing books. You know, in the past, not nowadays so much, but in the past.We used to be able to distribute books in the airports in the USA.
就是老师在讲到，就是他们之前在派书，在美国派书，在路上派书的时候，然后在机场派书。
This one devotee was distributing books, and he offered a book to somebody. You know.
然后他就把一本书派给一个人，把书给。被揍了。
And what did the devotee do?
那这个奉献者做怎么回应呢
？He said, "Oh, thank you, Krishna."
他说啊，谢谢 Krishna。
Now the devotee he could have had a fight with the guy. You know, he was a strong devotee, he was a powerful man.
就是 这个奉献者他没有办法跟那个陌生人打到烟，他可以跟那个陌生人打到烟，他很强壮，但是他并没有这么做。
But he didn't do. Instead, he thought, "Thank you, Krishna."
但他最后说谢谢 Krishna。
Krishna's mercy.
这是 Krishna 的仁慈。
So Krishna can give you, and Krishna can take.
就是 Krishna 可以给你，也 Krishna 可以取走。
Prabhupada said, "God is like someone with 10 arms."
圣帕巴有说，那个主，Krishna 就好像有十个手臂。
Ten arms. 一个好像一个十只手。
对，就是
在
十只手臂啊 ，ten arms
是。And we have only got two arms.
那我们就是两只手。
So if Krishna wants to give us something with ten, I can give a lot.
所以当 Krishna 想要送我们东西的时候，就是有十倍，他有十只手臂，这样十倍的东西。
And if Krishna wants to take with his ten,
所以当 Krishna 想要取走东西的时候，也是一样，那个十只手伸过来了。
So we have to thank Krishna.
所以我们需要感谢 Krishna.
When we suffer, we should think that actually I'm only suffering a little.
所以当我们遭受痛苦的时候，我们要想到就是说，哎。我们很幸运的，我们只受到这一点点的痛苦。
Actually, I'm so fallen, I'm such a rascal, I deserve to suffer much more.
就是。
因为我是特别堕落一个人，我是。
就是我要想说，我这么堕落的人，其实我应该遭遇到更多的痛苦的，但是我很谢谢 Krishna 只让我遭受这么一点点。
And when we're happy, we should think, I don't deserve this, but Krishna wants to encourage me.
就是说，当我们在开心的时候呢，我们要想说，我并不渴求这些，但是那个，很谢谢 Krishna， 就是给我这样的一个鼓励。
So, in every situation, we have to see the mercy of Krishna.
所以。不管是在任何的情况之下，我们都要就是想念 Krishna， 谢谢 Krishna。
And we have to thank Krishna.
我们需要感恩 Krishna。
We were hearing yesterday, Queen Kunti was describing about the lotus flower and seeing everything in relation to Krishna.
我们在昨天师姐里面有提到，就是昆蒂皇后，她就是说她在看 Krishna 的时候是所有的莲花她都可以联想到是 Krishna。
So here today we're hearing that calamity, difficulty, all the problems, we should thank Krishna.
所以今天我们所学的就是要去了解到昆蒂皇后就是。教我们就是在面对任何困难的时候，我们都要想到 Krishna。
So that is the secret of Krishna consciousness。
那这个就是那个 Krishna 直觉。
To see everything is the mercy of Krishna。
将所有的事情，都视为是 Krishna 的仁慈。
So we say, let there be calamities。
Calamities。
Troubles.
就是让
在呢。Let there be calamity.
就是灾难在哪里呢？
可以有灾难。
就是说我们接受灾难的存在。
This is Queen Kunti's prayer.
这是昆蒂皇后的祈祷文。
Well, there doesn't have to be calamity. But we have to be Krishna conscious.
就是我们不需要这些苦难，都是还是需要有 Krishna 意识。
And the result is if we're thinking of Krishna, then apunar bhava darshanam, no more birth and death.
就是不再有，我们不需要再面对这些生死轮回。
Bhava darshanam, seeing birth and death.
就是Bhava darshanam, 就是面对生死轮回。
And apunar, not again.No more.
Apuna 就是不再。
The end of material life.
就是物质生活的终点。
结束了。Okay. So this is something we have to practice in the course of our life. There will be problems.
这就是我们。在生命的议题中需要学习的就是说生命总是有一些困难 有问题
You can make a list of all the problems you may have
我们可以写一个清单就是我们遭遇了一些什么问题
Employment problems Trying to find the right job
就是试图去做正确的工作做正确的事情
Economic problemsTrying to pay the bills for everything.
经济的就是有经济的困难就是试着去用金钱解决。
And then marriage problems.
然后婚姻的问题。
And then children problems.
然后有孩子的问题。
And then health problems.
然后身体的健康的问题。
Endless problems.
就是无止境的问题、
One after another.
一个接着一个
So how to cope with them? How to, when the problems come, what should we do?
就是我们怎么跟这些困难共存呢当这些困难来临的时候我们该怎么做呢
We should First we should think thank you Krishna
就是首先我们就要想了感谢 Krishna
And then take shelter Devotional service
然后就是托庇在就是奉爱的奉爱服务这样
Do more chanting and hearing
就是做更多的念诵圣名还有聆听
By chanting and hearing You can overcome all problems
借由唱诵跟聆听你可以征服所有的困难
Okay Any question?
Guru Maharaj in the Bhagavad、it says that all the difficulties they are like a dream Does it say that? Like, she read in Chinese I thought
Oh yeah, right Prabhupada speaks about the dream、so. Well, yes It's like a dream The problems are like a dream
就是在钥匙里面圣帕尔提到就是说所有的灾难所我们所经历的灾难就是一场梦而已
And Prabhupada gives the example Tiger is coming to eat me
就是圣帕尔举了一个例子就是说、哎、老虎在梦里面老鼠要吃了我老虎要吃了我
So the same way you know we have all of these dreams we have the night dream and you have the day dream
就是说其实像人生这一切都是梦哦我们有白日梦也有晚上做的梦
Then we dream you know we dream oh I'm a great football player 我是那么好的一个球员我会踢足球那么好啊 I'm such a good football player
就是说有时候我们会自我感觉良好认为我是一个很好的足球员
Or I'm a great businessman
我是一个很厉害的那个生意人
Or we dream I'm a rich man
有时候我们会做梦觉得我是一个有钱人
Somebody else dreams I'm a poor man
有时候有人也会觉得我是一个可怜人。
But all of these things are temporary.
但是这些现象都是短暂的。
Right, they're finished. They're finished with the body.
他们会跟着你的身体而结束。
And very most they're finished with, and often they're finished even before the body.
所以在你躯体结束之后呢，其实这些一切都消失了。
So the problems, the things which come in our mind, they're just like so many dreams.
所以这些问题就好像那个各种梦境一样。
Of course, sometimes it's more like a nightmare than a dream.
所以有时候这些就好像我们晚上做梦一样。
噩梦。
噩梦，噩梦。
The problems, they're all temporary, they're finished in the course of time.
这些状况都是短暂的，那都会有结束的时候。
So that's why Prabhupada compares them to dreams.
所以这也是为什么圣帕巴用梦境来比喻。
Okay, any other question? No? Okay.
Maybe you could tell them how to get to wake up from the dream.
How to wake up from the dream.How to wake up from the dream?
Chant Hare Krishna. And remember Krishna.
Teaching life. Yes. Lord Chaitanya is calling Jeev Jago. Wake up, sleeping. Like chanting Hare Krishna. Wake up.